Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, we love you. We love you. Could somebody tell Jesus, I love you? Express yourself to him tonight. He is your lover. He is your all in all. Just open your heart. And as you open your heart, you'll hear that freedom. That inward man that have so much trouble, he will get that freedom. Hallelujah. My God. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, Mama, she called me Shanda, Kitty, Rebe Shanda. Rebecca Shanda, Yabababa, she called me Shanda. Ah, she undulumo, Kitty, yes, Kitty, Yibi. God, have your way tonight. Have your way tonight. Speak, Lord. Speak through this vessel. I speak, Lord, that your anointing will fall in every heart and give them that freedom to listen tonight what you have to say. So many times we miss the message. And Father God, I pray against every forces of the enemy that seeking to tempt our mind, to detour it from the presence and the operation of your spirit tonight. And Father God, tonight we break every shackle of the powers of the prince of the air right now. And we pull down every stronghold. And we command your anointing to flow in this environment. And break every power, break every shackle, oh God, in this community. In the name of Jesus. And touch every home in this community. Bring conviction that they will turn to the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you. Praise you. You may have your seat. Thank God tonight. I'm so glad to be here with you another year. Amen. You know, Santa comes once a year. Amen. Well, I'm not Santa. Amen. Hallelujah. I come to join with you to rejoice. Hallelujah. Rejoice for the many years that you have labored. Some have labored and gone. But thank God you are here. Amen. And you're determined to fight on. Hallelujah. And you cannot quit until Jesus says to quit. Amen. Hallelujah. In this ministry, there is no retirement. Amen. Hallelujah. There's no retirement in this ministry. Amen. You got to work. Hallelujah. Jesus said, I must work the work until, hallelujah, the night come. Amen. And today is day. Today we call it today. We got to walk. Amen. We thank God tonight. Amen. From the open church and you begin ministry. And though some of these folks in there could not come, my wife was not able to be here. She come down, get out of the cold. Hallelujah. But just lift your hand. Amen. Outreach. Amen. And just give God praise. Thank God for our brethren. And I thank God for Pastor William, who continue to stand strong. Amen. In spite of all the battle. Amen. He and his wife and the deacon and those among him. Amen. Surely the Lord is in this place. When I came in here, I felt the anointing was flowing in this place. Amen. Amen. There is no worshippers here, but I just stand here and feel the presence of God. And I know there's something good took place this week. I know something great went on this week because I get it in my spirit. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm the least of all preachers. But I tell you, I love Jesus. Amen.
Yes.
And hallelujah. I don't compromise with nobody. Not my wife, my mother, my brother, my sister. Amen. Hallelujah. Give me $1 million and I still will preach against you. Amen. I'm the preacher, your money don't dazzle me. Hallelujah. I left all that I have for the gospel's sake. And I'm determined to die for the gospel. When I came to America some years back, I preached on the street and I preached against the homosexual then. And I tell them that is not what God made you for. And one, I never knew that there was one right next to the church. And the first night he came and gave a message to those people who were sitting and tell the pastor, don't preach, stop preaching that kind of message. And when he told me, I get real bad. And the next night he came and he confronted me. That he said, I'm going to get my agency and my lawyer, and we're going to sue you. I said, listen to me, you can do what you want, but you cannot fight against the one who sent me. Amen. Hallelujah. He know how to stop your breath. He know how to cut you short. Amen. But don't stretch your head against the gospel preacher. And you know, a couple days after, he and his so-called girlfriend break up. And the mother come to me for me to pray for them. Listen to me. Don't let nobody fail you. Amen. When it's wrong, it is wrong.
Amen.
But tonight I want to share with you, we read the scripture over and over. Amen. And in Revelation 22 and from verse 12. Amen. I trust I won't be long. Hallelujah. Just give it to you and just get out. Amen. Hallelujah. And tonight I want to share a couple of points here. Amen. 4 points I want to share. Number one, be alert.
Yes.
Be ready. Be prepared. Jesus is about to come. Praise God. Number two, the reward. Surely you will have your reward.
Yes.
Number three, the last warning. Praise God.
Oh, yes.
And number four, hallelujah.
Jesus.
Praise God.
Praise
God. The last warning. Hallelujah. And the last invitation. Amen. You know, when Pastor William asked me, give me the scripture, you know that it was the first time for all these years I've been preaching that somebody asked me to preach in Revelation. And I say, wow. Why? Because very rare you hear preaching on the book of Revelation. And the reason why, Because it seems that a very hard book to understand. Amen. Hallelujah. And a matter of fact, if you're going to try to understand the Bible with your carnal mind, you will only understand what your carnal mind tells you.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But just to go back to the beginning of the book, in the book of Revelation 1 and verse 10. Hallelujah. And I'd like to talk about the writer, the messenger.
Yes.
Amen. Because he was in a position. He positioned himself.
Yes.
God positioned him for he to talk to him.
Yes.
Amen. And the reason why we cannot hear from God, because we're not in the position that God wants us to be in. Hallelujah. Some of us are too careless and too coward. Amen. But this man John, he was called by Jesus Christ, anointed with the Holy Ghost, followed Jesus. And after he was called to be an apostle. Amen. You know, we have a lot of apostles today. A lot of doctors and a lot of shepherds and a lot of people. But let me tell you something, it's who God called. And when God called you, he will position you because he have a work for you. He have a mission for you. And this man John, amen, received the commission from Jesus Christ. And John, amen, continued preaching the gospel. After the Holy Ghost came upon them in Pentecost and continued. And John was prepared to die for the preaching of the gospel. And so John, the Bible said that John was in the island of Patmos. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He was put there under the Roman authority for a crime that they branded him, amen, that he committed because they hate the gospel. Amen. They don't want to hear the gospel.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And sometimes it's important for God to allow you to go through some persecution in your life. As a matter of fact, if some of you never went through some persecution, you would have never come to Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. And persecution is not a bad thing. It's a good thing. It's because of the fear that we have, and we allow fear to creep us. But you need to grow to understand the purpose of persecution. Amen. And if you notice in the Bible, read in the Bible, that all the great men from the Old and the New Testament, amen, and they talk about experiencing the God of heaven, they have went through something in their life that caused them to reach a place where they experience God and God alone. Amen. Hallelujah. And this man John in the island, he said, I was in the isles of Patmos. He said, I was in the spirit on the Lord day. Hallelujah. He was put in the little Asian island where they sent criminals to put people there to die. Not only to die, but in a vicious beast there, their men to finish kill them. Hallelujah. But I tell you that, amen, that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that they didn't care about what Nebuchadnezzar do, because they knew that God will save them. And because of willing to stand up and take, amen, the suffering, and don't deny God, but continue to magnify him in your circumstances, God is able to show himself to you.
Amen.
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 Amen. What's about Brother Job?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, I heard about Job. Amen. Hallelujah. I heard about God and I read about Him, but now my eye have beheld Him, because I know whom I believe. I'm persuaded that He's able to keep that which I've committed until the day. Put your hand together for Jesus, according to the Apostle Paul. Amen. And listen, Jesus repeat a word. He tell Peter, upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Amen. Not prevail against it. And the church that Jesus Christ built, not Pastor William, the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. The church is not, amen, denominational. It's not outreach. It's not about the name of your symbol. We live in a time when people begin to follow after names. Yes. And so it caused division among God people. And people began to run here and run there. But what the people need is to know the name that is above every other name. Because at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And John said, hallelujah, I was in the spirit,
yes,
on the last day. Hallelujah. I was in the spirit.
The spirit.
Hallelujah. You see, we thought the spirit, you are nothing. We thought the spirit, amen, is waste of time that you're going and preaching, saying God sent you. Amen. This man, hallelujah, in that condition, put in a hot cup of oil, according to history, and amen, take him out from that cup of oil and place him in the Asian Sea to die. Hallelujah. But let me tell you something, that nothing happened to you without God knowing. And nothing happened to you that is looked so bad without God's permission. Amen. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
And so in everything, give him thanks.
Yes.
Instead of worrying and troubling about a little cold, a little headache and the cancer and this, listen, he's cancer boss.
Yes.
Amen. He's diabetes boss. He's,
yes,
boss. When the doctor said there's no cure, hallelujah, you have a big brother who is able to heal you, amen, and set you, amen, on your feet and cause you to rejoice. But I love this man, John. You see, when you, when God fills you with the Holy Ghost, you are just not yourself, brother. You are just an instrument prepared to be used by God. And God will take care of that instrument. Hallelujah. And so God allowed them to take John and put him and burn him and bring him to that place because God wanted Paul, even Peter, even John on that place. Hallelujah. He wanted to communicate with God. With John. But John was too busy preaching the gospel and going down to Asia and preaching and seeing signs and wonders. Hallelujah. And God said, now, you see, you're too busy for me. I'm going to take you and bring you to a place that I will communicate with you. You see, when God made man, he made man to communicate with man.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Man is the masterpiece, God's masterpiece. And so God, hallelujah, want to communicate with us.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You see, God is not the pastor.
No.
Some of us want the pastor to talk to us. That's nice. Some of us over here prophet and tongue, we run for a word. Well, where is God? You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You, when you come to church, open your spirit and wait upon God for a word.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. And so sometimes God has to bring you to a place that He will communicate with you. And if He takes you to bring you into bed, and if He takes you, amen, to bring you somewhere, in the prison or somewhere, God wants to communicate with you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And so as he desired to communicate with John, hallelujah, and John began to praise God in his condition. John didn't worry about his life. John knew a pass from death unto life. John knew departing from this life is to be with Jesus. Hallelujah. And John knew that. And that's what we need to know that too, because death shouldn't scare us. That is just a transport to take us to the better life. Amen. And so John was not thinking about death. I mean, that man had pain. Some of you ladies cook. Let me see. All those who get a burn from the stove when you're cooking, lift your hand. And you know the little pain that you get when you get that pain. Man, just think about this man when he was in that hot oil, in that copper. And amen, they took him out there. When oil burn you, he peel your flesh and leave your skin and leave your flesh. Hallelujah. And you say, oh, that can be of God. Some of us, we say that can be of God. A matter of fact, we have some people in church today that as soon as something happened to them, they start to bind them. You get what I'm saying? God working and God bringing you to a place that He wants to minister to you. But you binding devil. Amen. What the devil could do to you that God don't know. A matter of fact, the Bible said, hallelujah, if God is for me, who on earth could be against me?
That's the word.
Amen. You know what I'm saying? And so this man was in a place where Jesus could have communicated with him. And so that he was in the spirit. And the reason why that people don't understand the book of Revelation is because it came from the spirit. It came from the mouth of Jesus. From the heart of God to a man's heart that have a heart for him that he could trust that he will put it on paper and he will send it out.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Praise God.
Praise
him. And so John, amen. And if you read the book of Revelation, amen, from 1, hallelujah, from chapter 1, right to 12, there's so much thing that John had to pen in his spirit. And John had to write it. Amen. So, in chapter 1, how did John saw? John, the vision of the Son of Man.
Yes.
Chapter 1. In chapter 2 and 3, the message to the seven churches. Hallelujah. So after John had the experience with him, then John was given a message for the church. And then in chapter 4 to 5, amen, after this thing, the Lord took him and bring him in the heaven place. And he saw the heaven open.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So he saw things or not. He saw him walk in the midst of the candlestick, hallelujah, and he kept the message for the seven churches, and so that he ended up, amen, God took him, and after this thing, he saw heaven open.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah. And in verse 6, the first six seal. Hallelujah. The seal that no man could not understand and could not open. They could not break the seal. And John weep. Amen. Who is able to seal, break that seal and open that seal. But thank God, you see one hiding from the tribe of David. Amen. The bright and monished. He saw, amen, the lion of the tribe of Judah came and took the shield. Amen. And John and the angel and everybody in heaven watching John and Jesus. Hallelujah. Unfolding it. Praise God in chapter 7, 144. Amen. The great multitude and that one church that we have, amen, going around and saying that we are the 144,000. But they go read the Bible. The Bible says 144,000 out of the tribe of Israel.
Yes, yes,
amen.
Yes.
You see, they can't understand it. Hallelujah. In 10, 8 to 10, you have the trumpet plays, and you have, amen, 11, the two witnesses, amen, that they will kill and they will rise back to life, they will rise back to life. And in chapter 12, you have the woman, the child, and the dragon. Amen, hallelujah. And in chapter 13, amen, the two beasts. And 14, the land, and the 44,000, and the three angel message. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. God in action. Christ in action. And in, amen. And in 15, hallelujah, 16, the bold judgment, the seven last plague. Hallelujah. And in chapter 17 to 18, the mystery of Babylon, the mother of Harlot, amen, and the abomination that Jesus Christ, hallelujah, amen, decided to come and deal with them. Hallelujah. And amen. Hallelujah. 19, the return of Jesus. Amen. The beast and the air armies defeated. Hallelujah. And in chapter 20, the great white throne, yes, the judgment, and in 20 and 22, amen, amen, the new heaven and the new earth. So a matter of fact, that, amen, in Revelation is a continuation of what John saw about the new heaven and the new earth. Amen. Hallelujah. But Jesus stepped in the play from things, amen, in 18, Jesus stepped in. Hallelujah. 19, Jesus stepped in. 20, Jesus stepped in. Hallelujah. And amen, in 20, amen, he come down with vengeance. Amen. I heard of a story of a church, some, amen, once that, you know, he was going, amen, on his way, walking along a place, and he saw a young man in a pond that he was jogging. And so he reached out to him, and he rescued him from jogging. And after some years, that he was trying a case, and this young man commit a crime, a murder. And amen. And when he sit there, the judge look at him, and he said, "Do you remember a day, amen, when somebody came to rescue you when you were dying in this pond?" He said, "Yes." He said, "Do you remember who is this man?" He said, "No." He said, "I am the man. I was your savior when I met you in the pond, but today I become your judge." And he sentenced him to hang. Amen. No mercy. And so Jesus, when he came the first time, he came as the Lamb of God. He came, amen, as the Holy Lamb of God to make the sacrifice for sin. Hallelujah. And he suffered, bled, and died. Walk up Calcutta Hill. Hallelujah. Defeat the devil. Hallelujah. And put them to shame and make a new covenant. Hallelujah. And Jesus coming back again as the great church of all mankind. Hallelujah. So in the book of Revelation, chapter 10 and verse 12, we say, "Behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man, amen, every man, king, government, lawyers, and prime minister, and judges, they have to stand before me, because I'm coming back." Amen. You see, brethren, let me tell you something, that God will do nothing in secret. When he has to represent him on the altar. A matter of fact, the church represents Jesus on the church. Amen. Hallelujah. In this world. And to preach the gospel to every nation. And so, amen, we heard that the Bible declare that, amen, and the Spirit and the bride shall come. Hallelujah. You see, you have a part to play in Jesus coming to give. Hallelujah. Amen. He's the reward. But you've got to watch yourself. You catch what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Praise God. Behold, I come quickly. In one version say, behold, I'm coming soon. You see, man time is not God time. And because men don't understand God timing, we have a lot of prediction for years and years gone by that they said he's not coming, but he never come. Amen. You know, just reading some of them the other day, how much of them that day include Ellen G. White, the founder of the Seventh-day Adventist. We had one on the radio make some sacrifice and said, they're not coming, the world is going to end. And after that, he gave up his position and he died.
Yes.
You understand?
Yeah.
And he still had to face Jesus, you know.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You suffer here and you still have to face Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. So when he says something, he means,
yes.
You know, that reminds me about when he said that he, as I said, a virgin will be a child. Amen. His name shall be called Emmanuel. The prophet prophesied and told them about the coming of the Messiah. Israel supposed to know that the Messiah was going to come. But when the Messiah come, hallelujah, amen, God had to take men, wise men who studied the stars away back from Iraq down in the Middle East to come down and say, where is he that is to be born? King of the Jews, and the rabbi and those who study the Lord, they continue the church having the good time and weighing the long drum, amen, and rubbing the people and laying for them. Hallelujah. And the Messiah came, he sacrificed himself and gone, and Israel still looking for a Messiah to come.
Yes.
You hear what I'm saying? I just want to step out here a little while to let you know all these things you see happening with the ISIS and down in the Middle East. And you see that America have a lawless president. All these are God operation because God had to shake the world. He got to bring them come together because they must prepare for the man of sin to come.
Yes.
Prophecy.
Yes.
Amen. Israel is the center of prophecy. And if you want to learn prophecy, look at Israel. Study the temple they're building. Amen. They start building the temple. Hallelujah. They prepare the priests. And they prepare all the gold and things already. But one thing hindered them is because of the mosque, the Muslim veil. They call it the Dome of Rock. Amen. Hallelujah. And that, amen, that's the big struggle with them. Israel become one of the, amen, the wealthiest real estate today, Jerusalem. They make money more than any part of the world with Jesus tread, with Jesus buried. Hallelujah. But they're not getting ready for when he coming. And the church played a role in preaching to Israel and bringing them. The church played a role in preaching, amen, to the Muslim and the Hindu and the Baha'i, amen, and amen, and the Buddhism and all the different type of religion, because when Jesus wants them to hear the gospel message, a matter of fact that the Lord has given them knowledge concerning the modern technology, so there will be no excuse for the gospel preaching, and where they could not carry a tract, they could not carry a Bible, they would kill them. Hallelujah. Today they have the cell phone, they have the computer, and they can see, amen, the program on the television. They can read a Bible, hallelujah, in their own language. That's the wisdom of God.
Yes.
And to hear some crazy people saying the church ain't good enough. Tell them it's a lie from the pitch of hell. You think that God put you here for amen for not? Amen. No matter some may go and some may come. When they grow, they go with something. They come, some just come to take something to go. But they go with something. And some come to bless you, brother. Amen. Hallelujah. And when the time comes, they must go. Don't find fault with them. Love them because, amen, you sow something into them that is good. Amen. And one of the things that we look for, the greatest thing that we look for, is the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And surely he will come. And when he comes, he's going to meet some people playing around. Amen. He's going to meet some people having a good time. In Matthew 24, he gave us signs, the signs of the time.
Yes.
And one of the known signs is Noah. Mm-hmm. Remember Noah days?
Yes.
How they were eating and drinking?
Yes.
They were marrying and divorcing.
Yes.
They had almost excellent lesbian too.
Yes.
Amen. God say these people heart is desperately wicked.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And God had to come down to see the imagination of man's heart.
Oh,
and when he gave Noah commission to build the ark and to preach, Noah building, Noah preaching.
Yes.
Just identical like the church today. We gotta preach, we gotta build.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Because God don't want nobody to miss it. That's why he come and give the final warning.
Yes.
The final invitation. That we should be prepared. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
But thank God. Hallelujah. He's coming. And Noah preached 120 years. And people don't listen. And if you check this time, in the same pattern.
My God.
Same pattern.
Yes.
People don't take serious about the gospel message.
Oh, Lord.
Hallelujah. Some people believe they have time. Some people believe when they get sick and they get old, then they will have enough time. Who tell you that life is not in your hand? Today is the day of salvation.
Yes.
If you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Amen. And let me say that to you. The thing that is going to make the judgment severe, it will be the worst judgment ever passed on planet Earth. The same loving God will turn his ears and revenge all those who refuse him. You see, my friend, the judgment that's going to come, Pastor William, is about God watch his son die by the hand of wicked men.
Yes.
The chunker, the prostitute, the criminal, and everybody joined together and kill him. The father gave them up. He said, Father, if possible, remove this cup. Not my will be done, but thy will be done.
Yes.
And let me tell you something, my friend, that God watched his son die by the hand of wicked men. It was one of the worst crimes that ever committed on the planet Earth when they nailed Jesus to the cross and beat him and pierced his soul on his side. And when, amen, they put a crown of thorn on his head and give him vinegar and gall to drink. Hallelujah. And he did it all for Adam's race. He did it all for every man. And when Jesus coming again, that's why he said, take the communion, my brother. Remind me about, hallelujah, my death. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. because he's coming again. My friend, listen to me today. Look, the people who refuse the gospel, they refuse the blood sacrifice for the remission of the sin. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I tell you, if you think this trouble, you're going to see trouble.